In our purchase or pass segment this week, we highlight some of the pros and cons of an investment and discuss whether or not we'd buy it. As always, the location is a given. It's the finer points of the decision that we're trying to concentrate on. Now, this week, we've got a three-bedroom townhouse in a small block of seven, 12.7 kilometres from the CBD, and just a couple of minutes' walk from the local action. It's in a very quiet area away from the road and is surrounded by lush gardens. There's an oversized timber entertaining area which opens out from the kitchen. They were asking $885,000 plus, and the rental estimate is around $8 to $850 a week. So Stuart, based on what you've seen so far, what would you say are some of the pros for the unit out there?
It's a good block. It's not too many apartments in the block. It's got a great entertaining area. It's something of which you can do a bit too. So I see a lot of potential in that property. The rent's actually pretty good in regards to the price, and I'm not shied away from that at all. So between the rent and the ability to improve value on it, I think it's actually got some good values right at the start.
And certainly being close to the area, but having your own private entertaining deck area is also a good thing. Everyone like coming in the summer for the barbies and stuff. And also getting balconies off the bedrooms is a good thing as well, isn't it?
Well, I mean, people are spending a lot more time at home these days. It's a lot more expensive to go out and do whatever you've got to do, you know, in bars and, you know, whatever else around there, restaurants. So everybody's actually having a bit more time at home and enjoying their time at home. So having entertainment areas and also places of which you can enjoy the kitchen and lounge room is very important.
Now, it's always very easy on these things, especially on the internet, to fall in love and say, oh, hey, it looks perfect. But if you delve a bit deeper, what would you say are maybe some of the slight negatives that you might pick up on?
Well, the floor plan is always important. I mean, not enough people spend enough time on the floor plan of a property. It's almost like you should start there and then move to the other photos. Because as you said, Chris, you can fall in love with a photo very easy. But I mean, the floor plan's got to be somewhere you spend a lot of time with, because they'll have measurements of rooms and have areas as far as where the bathrooms are, where the entry is. And you know, you don't want a door opening up into a lounge room. And those kind of things are very important when looking at a property. So although the photos might be great, but the photos are always photoshopped, and we always know what Photoshop means. They're always good. So I would have said, you know, you've got to be careful about and look at the floor plan.
Yeah, because the main things I picked up with that floor plan was that the entertaining area is actually off the dining in the kitchen rather than off the lounge, which isn't a great thing. But also the lounge looks directly at the walkway, and so you've got people from around the building walking past, and for security that's obviously not a good thing either.
And the worst thing about that too, mate, is that you won't notice it when you first view it the first time or second time. It's not until you live there and you're a month in or 2 months in and you start to not worry about the glossy stuff and you start to really live there and enjoy the life of it, and then you start saying, well, I don't really like the fact that people are walking past me every 5 minutes. You don't like the fact that, you know, they've got small bedrooms, and you don't like the fact that you can't get to the balcony without going through the kitchen. And these things all come back to roost.
Because those bedrooms look reasonably big in the pictures, but they're only about 7 square metres, so I don't reckon there's any way you're going to get a double bed and built-ins, which is going to be painful.
Well, the worst thing too is that the real estate agents are smart people, and they go, well, we'll put a single bedroom bed in there, and then it makes it look bigger. Or they'll do something as far as the mirror might be there to make it look bigger. And then so it makes it look like a big room, and then you get to put stuff in it and you go, oh, I can't find it.
Yeah. So what's your verdict on this one?
It's a pass for me. Although a couple of good things, but the second bedroom is really important. I mean, someone that wants to buy this might want to have a share person rent the other room, and you're not going to find anybody living in a share in a single bed these days.
Exactly. Look, there is a lot of positives on the property, but the standout negative for me as well is not having double bedrooms, because it is going to limit your market both for buyers and for renters. Now, the property isn't going cheap, so that would be enough for me to make a pass as well.